of a Father that screams over us. He screams over us an invitation to come up to a higher place.
Above the circumstances, above all fear and doubt.
He sings over us. You come under a mighty in the middle of the service. He sings, come up here. Come up here. And when we respond to the song of the Father and we join in that duet, then we become the song that He sings over our generation. The Spirit and the Bride say, come, all who are weary, all who are broken. See, once you respond to the Father, then you become the invitation to the world, to our generation. And you become the song in His heart that He sings and releases over the lost and the broken.
Thank you. we were in our living room in Brazil, and we were just in this time of worship, and I just began to sing and intercede for a particular woman who's a good friend of ours. And her name is Hosanna. She's been in prostitution for 25 years. And she's beautiful. So we were just singing for her. We were singing these lyrics, just interceding. And this song kind of came forth from it. And then about 2 weeks later, she was able to come over. And we were singing this song over her, and it was just beautiful because she's just sitting there crying, and we're crying, we're just making messes, you know. I love the messes of the Father. His messes are so much better than my plans. And so then after a while, Rachel goes and she grabs the spoil, and she just begins to anoint Mother's feet, anoint Hosanna's feet. And she's crying, and her tears are falling on Hosanna's feet. And Hosanna's crying, and her tears are falling on Rachel's face. And we're singing this song for her. And then she looks up at me after a while, and she says, "I have nothing to give him. I have nothing to give him." And she's just crying. I look at her and she says, "All I have is a broken heart. Everything that I am is broken. Everything that I am is dirty." And I just looked at her and I said, "Hosanna, that's exactly what God wants from you. It's your broken heart and your dirty past. Bring it to him as an offering." And he calls it beautiful. But see, the biggest part of worship is just learning to trust the Father. That we can come and say, "Here's my heart, Papa. Here's my past. I just bring it as an offering to you." And I love how the Father is like, "What's your wall one day? What's your struggle one day? Is your offer the next?" And he just smiles and you pray and you say, "Hey, Papa, here's what's been keeping me back from you. Here's my pride, my fears, my doubts, everything that's been holding me back. My sins, my struggles." And the Father smiles and says, "What a beautiful gift."
Learning to trust you. Thank you. Thank you.
guys good?
Yeah.
We're changing the reputation of Tuesdays. Amen? You know, in Brazil, they'll go all night every night. So, Monday, Tuesday, it doesn't matter if it goes 6 hours, 5 hours, whatever. So, you know, Brian said, like, that's what we want to do tonight. We just really want to. Somebody just got scared. I'm just kidding. It's okay. You're safe. It's a safe place. But I'm going to share a little bit in and out of some of these songs because I want you to kind of get what's going on. It's amazing because, you know, Rachel and I, my wife, she's in Brazil with our two little girls, and our time is kind of split, meaning like 50% of the time is on the streets with children in prostitution, and, you know, many women in prostitution as well, and people in drug addiction and alcoholism, things like that. And the other half is in the church training people to go to the streets. And so we're in this kind of mix all the time, like back and forth between the two. And it's a really interesting thing because what I've found is that ministry between the two is really not different, to be totally honest with you. The needs of a street child in Brazil who's being prostituted 20 times a night are the same needs as mine, the need for the Father. You know, it's like, when I look at this, it's like amazing. We go to the streets, you know, and when we get there, so there's these parks we go to in northeast Brazil, and there's, you know, there's dozens and dozens of kids. And they're hungry and stuff like that, but it's amazing because when we get there, the thing that they really want, what they're longing for, is a daddy. And so they're like, give me a big fat ride and throw me to the sky and kick a ball and spin me around. And by the way, there's 50 kids there and you need to spend one. The rest of the night is green. And they need like a bottle of Dramamine and just to be ready. So what I've learned, because, you know, I kind of like came up under Randy's teaching. So I learned impartation. What impartation looks like on the streets is that I spin one kid and then I point to my team and I impart to them the ability to spin the other 49 kids. It works wonderfully. It's great. So I learned that. But it's like the thing that they long for is the Father. That's what they're so hungry for. It's the presence of the Father. You can come. And what they want is like spin me around and pick me up and play games with me. Because what they're lacking is the presence of the Father. And then I come in churches, whether it's in Brazil or the United States, and the number one thing that people ask us to pray for is, please pray that I can see God's law, because I can't see his dead God. The needs are the same between the streets and the churches. God requires the same thing. I mean, my needs are the same. I need the Father. I need Papa. I need everything that I need. Nice man. His Papa. Everything that I need is found in his arms. Amen? And so, it's interesting, even the way God sees things. You know, like my dream, my calling is to Brazil. So my dream is to see an entire nation separate prostitution in my lifetime. And so, like Rachel and I, our team, we're fully committed to see that happen, to kill the giant of prostitution in Brazil, in our lifetime. It's a big dream. And some people say, oh, you guys are crazy. And we say, thank you very much. You just wanted to come, you know. But it's like, it's a big dream. Big thing, and some people think it's impossible. There's 2 million children in prostitution, there's millions more adults, and I'm like, that's nothing for God, it's nothing. But it's big, you know, for us. And then the other day I was on the streets, and we were sitting there talking to these kids about our rescue homes. And the way we introduced the rescue homes to them is the same way that God won your heart and you won mine, and tell them the Father's prepared a place for you. He has a home, he has a room for you. The Father's prepared a table for you. He has a place in the ministry. And so I'm telling this girl, and I said, you know, Father has a place for you in a spiritual sense, but in a literal sense. You need a house that you can come to, and you can have your own room and your own bed, and you can have your own closet with your own clothes. Nobody's going to steal from you. And I'm telling all this, and she's getting excited, and I'm saying, you know, you can go to school, and you can learn an instrument, you can learn how to paint, to dance, and you're going to get to learn how to be able to sit, and you're going to get to sit, all these things. And she looks at me, and just with these big eyes, and she's like, if I come to your rescue home, will I get to go to a salon? And it broke my heart. She said, I've never had my hair look pretty, and I would love to look pretty like the women on the billboards and signs out front of the stores. If I come to your house, will someone make me look pretty? And the Father said to me, her dream is no different to me than yours. Her dream of going to a salon, my dream of seeing a nation, including yourself, set free is the same for the Father. Because the song that he sings over us is freedom. The song that he sings over us is rejoicing. Quiets us with his love. We were on the streets of the sea, which is the city we're opening these first few rescue homes in. And there's a stretch there where, for about 5 kilometers, there's 4 or 5 girls on every corner. And so, how many of you have heard of Exodus Cry and Pirates DVD and all that stuff? And it from my house? Okay, well, you should check it out. It's really awesome. And their executive director was down with us on the streets of Brazil. We took them to the streets. And we're going to be partnering with IHOP to open a Justice House of Prayer in the worst section of the city that we can find in the nation of Brazil. And it's funny, by the way, telling the realtor that. They're like, so what are you looking for? You're like, drugs, violence, some of the beating, crime, stuff like that. And then they laugh until they realize you're serious. So we were working on doing that, so we were there with them, and we're walking, and we're taking roses and the Father's love letter, which we do sometimes, and we ran out of them. I mean, we went, in 3 hours, we walked 2 blocks, because there's so many people to talk to. And when we go to the streets, it's not like fulfilling outreach, it's going to see friends, understand the difference. Jesus didn't say that, you know, greater love has no one than laid down his life for a bunch of sinners. He said one laid down his life for his friends. And in this season, God wants to change our perspective of the world. Change the way that we see the lost. We see them as friends and sons and daughters, not as sinners. And so we go to see our friends. So we're talking, and as you can tell, I can do that. And so we walk across the street, and we run out of roses. And I see this girl, and when I see her, immediately I see a vision of her holding a microphone. And so as I'm walking across the street, I hear the Father singing over her. I love your song. I love your song. And I hear him singing that over her. And you know, Zephaniah 3:17 tells us that the Father sings over us with rejoicing and deliverance, and he quiets us with his love. What is the Father singing over? The prostitute. Rejoicing, freedom, and love. Not condemnation, disappointment, and judgment. Rejoicing, freedom, and love. What's the Father singing over you? Rejoicing, freedom, and love. And so our job as the sons and daughters is to hear what the Father is singing over the lost sons and daughters, and to declare the song of the Father. And so this is what we do on the street. We just ask the Father, we want to hear the song you're singing. And so, as we walk up to this girl, I hear him sing that. So I just say to her, hey, do you like to sing? And she kind of sheepishly says, yeah. I said, because I just heard the Father singing over you that he loves your song. He created you for this purpose. He's hidden the sound inside of you, and only you can release that sound. Only you can release that song. He absolutely loves it. He's madly in love. When you sing, even when you're in the shower and you think nobody hears you, he hears you and thinks it's beautiful. And at this point, she's just weeping, and I'm weeping, and we're just a big mess together. And then she tells us her name is Hamidas, and she's 18. She's just been prostituted for 3 months because she couldn't take care of her 2 daughters. Child services was going to take them away. And she said to me, I've been taking singing lessons because I hope that one day I can use my voice instead of my body to support my girls. Wow. So, what was the Father singing over her? The very thing that he's hidden inside of her heart. The very desire that he hid inside of her heart. So, what we do is we listen for the song of the Father, and then we become the song of the Father's generation to the lost in a very real way. And so, I just pray that tonight you would hear the song of the Father over you, because once you hear that and you respond, you just can't stop singing over the lost and over the broken. Amen.
And he talked about how his friend had a prostitute woman come to him. And she was telling Phil Yancey's friend, I make more money in 1 hour renting out my 2-year-old daughter than I do in one evening. And I remember reading that, and like honestly, guys, like being the father of a 4-year-old girl and being the father of a 3-month-old, like when I remember reading that, even before I had children, anger rose up inside me. But the girl doesn't know any different. And like what Nick is doing, like what Rachel are doing, and it's because of the revelation of the Father's love that they're able to go. And what Nick was singing earlier, I'm just like, you guys have heard me say this. Guys, everything we do is in response to what God did first. Everything. Everything. And when we see that, you can go into these deep, dark places. You can do it. You can take the love of the Father and rescue such people. And this man told this prostitute woman, he said, why don't you go to the church? Have you ever thought about getting help from the church? And she said, the church? I already feel bad enough about myself. Why would I want to go there? And Phil Gansey said, what has happened that the ones that used to run to Jesus are now running from him? And I read that and I said, it just broke my heart. And then the people here that attend this church, you guys know our heart for that stuff. And we are a house of restoration, and we're seeing people renewed and redeemed. We're seeing the alcoholic get free. We're seeing people's lives get changed. But it's only because what we received first, guys. Like Nick's saying, the song, everything we do is in response to what he did. Even our giving, guys, what we're going to do right now, it's because he first gave. Guys, it's God's nature to give. It's got to be our nature to receive. And then to be able to give that away. So I listen, guys, I believe in what Nick and Rachel are doing down there. I do. It is honestly, Nick doesn't know this, it's my hope, my goal to come down and see it with my own two eyes. It just is. I'm telling you guys, the revelation that they carried wasn't joking. Nick wrote the foreword for my book. I wouldn't have had it any other way, guys. They understand the love of God. And it's the only thing I care about. I must know him. And when you give, guys, listen to me. I'm not huge on pushing offerings. I'm just not. When you give, I truly believe Matthew 6 is all about flesh dying through motive, you coming to know him more through prayer, fasting, and giving. I'm just convinced of that. So as you give tonight, this is what I want you to do. If you're making out checks, I want you to make them out to Praise Community Church. Listen, that all of this is going. It's going right to Nick and the ministry that they're doing, the Shores of Grace down in Brazil. We give them money every month. We believe in it. It's one of the ministries we support, and it's just an honor to sow into them. And Adam and I were talking about that, and people like Robbie and these different ministries that are happening here. They're kingdom-minded ministries that we're sowing into, guys. So if you want to give tonight, you want to do it by check. We're going to make checks out with Praise Community Church. Then we're going to write Nick just a big church check at the end of the night. So if I could have some able-bodied praise men come up here and just help with the baskets, Mike Smith, come up, David. Adam, if you want to help stand, it doesn't matter. We have the baskets up here. They're going to pass them around. I just want to pray. I want to pray multiplication over this stuff, guys. I believe in what they're doing. I believe in seeing the word over our house, guys. I believe it's what Rick is talking about, guys. Isaiah 61, the Spirit of the Lord God is on me for this reason, to bind the brokenhearted, guys. To set captives free. The same Spirit is on me, guys, for this purpose. To proclaim the favorable year of God. Because he's not angry with us. He's a loving Father. It's just good. I ask right now, Jesus, as these baskets are being passed, Holy Spirit, Father, God, I pray for multiplication, God, of what's being sown right here, God. On behalf of the ministry of Shores of Grace, on behalf of what they're doing, Father, you just increase and bless the buildings, God, and their team, the family, the kids. Thank you that your hand is upon them. Thank you for vision, God. Thank you, God, that nobody on that team, God, that Nick, Rachel, nobody's perishing for lack of vision, because they have it, God. You poured it out upon them. And I thank you, God, that you are literally, guys, did you hear that? They're rescuing child prostitutes. What do you do with that? I can't sit here and amen something like that, because I'm just like, I don't even know what that even looks like. It's just an honor to be around a guy like this. They want to see prostitution ended in Brazil, guys. That's amazing. That's a kingdom perspective, and I believe it's going to happen. Father, would you just bring it, God, even more? Thank you for your hands upon them. Thank you, Jesus, for strengthening them. God, we pray for multiplication. Thank you that you've given seed to the sower, God. And it's our joy, it's our honor, God, to sow into things like this, God. It's good soil. And I believe that even in our giving, Father, we're the flesh dies and we come to know you in an even greater way. Because it's your heart to give, and you want your children to receive. Thank you, Father, for everything you did first, and we may be. we can serve because you came to serve and not to be served. So Father, thank you that we get to live through you and not for you. And thank you that it's the love of God, the truth, and the value of who we are that's setting prostitutes free and preserved. The truth that makes walking in grace worth doing. Thank you for revelation.
Impartation, and that might not even be the real word, but this is the feel. God wants to just walk through walls tonight. I love how Jesus walked through walls, didn't you? Don't you? It's like the disciples are in the upper room and they're hiding in fear, they're hiding in doubt, and what does Jesus do? It's like, don't bother about the door, I'm going to walk through the walls. And some of you, the reality is some of you have fear and doubt and rejection, and they're walls that are keeping you from hearing the song of the Father. So come up front. Right?